this one is perhaps not so obvious to a lot of people, and here it is. Thinking that online is the same as offline, okay? So you want to build a business online, or at least part of your business. You want the leads and, you know, contacts, connections, etc., to come from offline activities. Now, you make a big mistake if you think that online is the same as offline. It is not. It's not the same. No way is it the same. There are some similarities, but it's not the same as, because you can't eyeball people. You can on a Zoom call or something like that, but it's not the same as looking someone in the eye, shaking their hand, feeling their energy. You know what I'm saying? It's different. And because of that, I would say it's a lower trust way of doing business online. It's lower trust. There's more skepticism. There's more suspicion. It's just harder in some ways to build the trust and get that know, like, and trust factor working in your favor. It's harder. Doesn't mean that the difficulty is overwhelming. No, not at all, because here I am almost 12 years later and I'm still doing it and still loving it, right? So, but it's like anything. It's like baking a cake. There's always a recipe, and your job is to figure out what that recipe is, or to buy it, or to pay someone to help you with it, or whatever. But it's a formula. It's a recipe, and it's just different. And the reality is that you have to do more work to build trust with online. It's much easier. If I meet somebody in the local community at a networking event or something like that, shake their hand, hey, if it's a good strong handshake, they like me, you can feel it. You can feel it almost straight away that maybe they like you, maybe they're feeling positive about you. Well, trust in a way has already been partially established. Now, sure, that you'll need to talk to them a bit more, but it is easier and it's faster. It's faster. People say the online world is faster. No, that's another myth. It's not faster. In some respects, it's slower. It's slower. Now, look, when I first got started, I made money quite quickly. So I sound like a contradiction. I made money quite quickly. But I did it there's two ways that I did it. One way was that I plugged in to my existing little audience. In other words, my circle of influence. And these were people from the offline world. You see, that's why it was faster. And the other reason why it was faster is because I used paid ads. I used Google AdWords, and that worked pretty well. But by the end of that first month, I'd made almost 10 grand. By the end of that first month, most of the money came from those contacts that I had in the offline world. I made about 2,800 from the online, but I spent 600 on the ads, all right? I think it was 650, something like that. And so it was profitable, don't get me wrong. It was profitable, and I made a lot more in the second month. The fact of the matter is, the bulk of it, the majority of it, came from the contacts, the warm audience. In other words, the people that already know, liked, and trusted me in the offline world. You get it? Yeah. So I don't want to put you off the online thing at all, because I'm an advocate for it. But all I'm saying is that with the online side of things, there's less trust. And it takes longer to establish trust. So how do we establish trust? Well, one way is with content, good content, and not just picture quotes and things like that. Not just photos of funny cats doing stupid things, right? No, it's got to be more than that. It's got to be something from you that kind of resonates with people. Particularly if you know what their pain points are, if you can create a piece of content that talks about it and maybe offers some kind of a little solution, well, yes, that will help to establish trust. It will. It'll help to establish trust. So that's one way of doing it, with content. I'm talking text-based content, but what about video content? What about a Facebook Live? This is the next best thing to, you know, talking to people in a room where they can eyeball you and feel your energy and your spirit and all the rest of it. It's the next best thing. Okay, so there are things that you can do, and certainly Facebook Live and video has been a bit of a godsend, and I've done very well with video over the years because I think it's more powerful. It's a more powerful way to establish trust. Okay, so who else? Yes, Megan. Yes, glad I caught this. Yeah, great. Great, Megan. Okay, so thinking online is the same as offline. Guys, it is not the same. It is not the same. So you've got to kind of shift your thinking to a degree and say, okay, well, if it's not the same, if the internet is essentially a low trust kind of environment, and even a platform like Facebook is essentially a low trust platform, unless you already knew the people offline beforehand, we have to do more. We have to go all out to get that know, like, and trust factor working in our favor. Now, you've probably heard it before, know, like, and trust. But look, hey, it's still the early part of the year. Let's revisit some of these great truths, these great principles and rules for doing business. So we've got to do even more to build trust, to build likability in the online space. So question I've got for you. Are you doing enough right now? Are you doing enough to build the trust, to establish trust? Instead of thinking about making money, oh, I've got to make money, got to make money. Hey, let's focus on our passion, number one. Number two, let's start building some trust by creating some content that knocks people out, that hits them between the eyes and say, wow, she is talking directly to me. She is talking directly to me. Now, when you can get your content to that point, wow, your audience building activities are going to become so much more productive, so much easier. It's just going to be a magical, wonderful experience for you. No doubt about it. Megan says, yeah, I had someone reach out the other day after a live saying thank you for the live and that I really touched them. Yes, that's great. That's a great testimonial a great endorsement for what I'm saying. G'day, Kyle. Kyle from Sydney. How you doing? Good to see you, mate. Jean. Hi, Jean. How are you? Hope to talk to you soon, one-on-one. Okay. All right. So that's number two. That is number two. Thinking that the offline is the same as online. It's not. We have to do more work to build trust.